First, let me go around and check this area. Oh wait. There is these. Sit. Come back, I'm doing this for a let's play. There's actually random stuff I didn't even notice the first time. Is there a store in this area? Tell you the truth, I don't remember there actually being a store, so I might actually have a costume that I have to go back and get after Bowser and all that. That probably actually have a whole store. Which means new costume, you know? My god. Alright, let's see here. Oh, look at that. They got a couple of these in the first, when I was first playing the game, but then... As you know, a white raspy sham way to destroy you. Homie can't throw up. You throw your cap, shake the Joy-Con up. Okay, I know that, okay. Porsche doesn't do anything against those rocks. Unless I can find the T-Rex and bring him down here. See, this one has one of those guys in it. Do anything if I stomp on it? No, not really. Okay. Anyways, let's go ahead. I'm gonna destroy this rock real quick. Hey, I don't actually have coins, alright. I'm not completely rich yet, so I kinda need these. Hold on, hold on. There we go, okay. Sorry, I just wanna get just one more. There we go. Apparently, I did not have anything, but oh, wait, hold on. What are these used for? Can I jump on these? Oh, I see. Oh, I see. This little makes you a little stir crazy so you can actually get back up here. Question is, your shit in the water? I don't think there is actually. Go ahead and make our way up here. Alright, we got one moon, that should be enough, right? Ta-da! So, are we good? Alright then. Man, it's like ancient hatships over here, what the heck? Okay, now, how do we find this, our little T-Rex over here? Ah, there he is. Oh, there was actually stuff at the bottom. Okay, I have to go to that water area later. Oh shit, I don't know if it's a good idea going... Can I get back up? I might be able to get back up. Da 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 da. Oh, this is cool, look at it. He's a Mario T-Rex. Mamma mia. Oh, you know me, just causing havoc. What I do. Oh, damn it, it runs out. I gotta go back and get some of those coins. That's funny, because at first I was thinking like, nah, that water looks shallow. I don't think there's anything. Like, dang it, there actually was shit. Okay, hold on. Now we can actually make our way up here. You know what I mean, guys? I mean no harm. These ones actually really try to attack me much. Oh, I am the king. I know the way. I always love the amount of details Nintendo actually puts into half of these guys. Jeez, oh, not far enough. Okay, whatever. I know how to do this one. I'll just shake our controller like so, and ta-da! And as for over here, we have more coins. More coins that we needed to grab. So where is it? Becoming the new Banjo-Kazooie. So I have my roommate, he beat this game and he's still finding new worlds and areas to collect stuff. Like, it just doesn't end. But my question is, where the hell is the story in this area? I don't know why, that's my first thing I always want to do when I hit a new area is the first thing I do is try to collect the coin so I can get the costume for the area. I don't know why. It's more of an aesthetic thing, but I enjoy it. Oh shit, we got an old school Mario level. Da-da-da-da-da. Careful. Oh shit. No, I didn't want to destroy both of those. Cause some of these parts, wait, can I? Oh, I can. Okay, hold on. Aha! There's a moon in this area. Probably must have been one of the moons I might have actually missed my first playthrough around. But we still have quite a few other moons I missed. Oh wait, no, she's gonna give me a triple moon. Never mind, we're good. Hey! The heck, man? There we go. Ouch. Run, 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 run! And you. Oh no, you scary lady.
Don't you want some of Grandma's kisses?
Actually, to tell you the truth, I don't think I really fought her too many times more in the game.
Yeah.
Oh, hell no. No, I'm rebelling, lady. Your doggy doesn't love you no more. Take that. Oh no, angry. She said, ah, shit, not again. No. 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 Okay, now there. Okay, so this one's actually three. I'm guessing the first one was just two, kind of like a little starter boss. Ooh, she's a pink bunny now. Look at that. There we go. Hey, I like that look better. That's so kawaii with the ball chain face on her. There we go. We can repair the ship.
Yeah.
Is that on top of that bowl there? You know, the interesting part is there's a ton of stuff that's like so much extra crap that I actually discovered. Now they're taking me back to the ship. Yeah, pretty much you can keep going around the level for quite a while and still keep finding new stuff. Now we can repair the ship. Actually, yes. Oh, wait, no, we need it for, okay. I was thinking, oh yeah, didn't I get an extra? I'm like, wait, no. Wait, that doesn't explain something. Where the hell is a shop in this area? Let's see, do I have to get on it right away or should I? I don't know. I might check it out later. Off to our first destination, the desert. That also apparently has a bunch of ice. Oh no, mamma mia! Future is here. We got flying ants, giant dinosaurs. This is crazy. But sir, what are we using for fuel? Moons. What? Oh, look at me. I am the captain now. Yeah, we did it. We did it. Remember the first time when this desert level came up, there was a whole big debate on whether Mario wearing a sombrero and poncho was culturally appropriate, which I thought was dumb. Like, oh, that's racist. I'm like, man, he's a fictional Italian plumber wearing a sombrero and a poncho. Leave him alone, okay, guys? He's just trying to save the princess. He don't need all this political stuff. Also, fun fact, with collecting a lot of the coins, well, pretty sure a lot of you have played, but you can actually get, like, little souvenirs and stickers for your thing, which I didn't know until playing a decent portion through, so I was like, oh, shit, I need to go back. I need to pimp my ship out. Don't need an action guy, I knew how to play. Oh, the binding band. Hey, Bowser, you're setting everything up. They're gonna get the riches from all around the lands. Like, seriously, Princess, get some decent security. Cause I don't think the toads are, you know, gonna really threaten anybody, so. Oh god, that's so cool. Yeah, isn't this supposed to be the desert? The hell? How does that even happen? And see, really, if I wanted to, I could pretty much just wander aimlessly into the desert. And just strike back for, like, I don't know, give it a good hour I could do that for. So over here, so this one actually has a shop. Well, not meh. So let's see what I can afford. So here, oh yeah, I guess I can buy this. 150. And fun fact, you can also buy a moon in each level. Only one of them though, otherwise I'd make the level a little too easy. Alright, now we can travel in style. You know, I just totally used up all my coins, so let's try not to die too much. Okay, so first set will be... Hold on, we can do this. These up here. Let's see. Hey, we actually got a moon right here, which we need to use electricity right there. It shouldn't be too hard. I think I need a total of 15 in order to. Actually get the full sombrero and poncho. So we're almost there. So these areas actually legitimately does pay to sit there and look over the entire area, because there's random stuff that legitimately will be hidden. What's this right here? What does this lead to? Oops, sorry, okay, hold on. There's a prize in the room. We have to feel, oh, this one you actually have to feel the vibration for it. This one. I know for the Let's Plays, you guys are like, what are you doing? I was like, trust me, I can feel it. I can feel the 3D rumble. There it is, yay. We got an extra moon right there. Now if we can just find a few more of the purple pieces, we will be good.